Erythro stands for red and plakia for patch. Erythroplakia, classified as a potentially malignant disorder, is a red patch that cannot be clinically diagnosed as any other disease. It has had numerous definitions over the years since it was first defined in 1971. Erythroplakia was defined by World Health Organization in 1997 as a fiery red patch that cannot be characterized clinically or pathologically as any other definable lesion. The definition of erythroplakia is unusual in that the diagnosis is one of exclusion of other red lesions rather than depending on a definable appearance of the lesion. To make it easier to understand, let's say you have a patient with a suspicious red patch on the buccal mucosa. Now, since there are several other red lesions that look like erythroplakia, make sure it is not any of the other red lesions. Only after this could you make a diagnosis of erythroplakia. Hence, it is a diagnosis of exclusion. The pathogenesis of erythroplakia is not fully understood, and tobacco chewing and alcohol drinking have been implicated as strong risk factors for the development of erythroplakia. Candida albicans and human papillomavirus have been demonstrated in patients with erythroplakia, though their role with relation to this lesion is still not very clear. There have also been reports where higher socioeconomic index, high income and education have shown to be associated with a decreased risk for oral erythroplakia and other oral premalignancies. There are red lesions that may occur on the palate in individuals who may have a habit of reverse smoking. That is, the tobacco product is reverse smoked with a lit or the burning end of the cigarette inside the oral cavity. Now, this form of smoking is called reverse smoking. And any red palatal change occurring as a result is not designated as erythroplakia, but is called as a reverse mucous palate. Now, these lesions are in fact classified as potentially malignant disorders. Several large-scale epidemiological studies have been conducted, and the prevalence of erythroplakia has been speculated to range from 0.02% to 0.83%. Erythroplakia is considerably lesser in prevalence than leukoplakia. There is no specific gender predilection for erythroplakia, and the older age group is usually affected. Erythroplakia has been reported in the 6th to 7th decade in the United States, while studies conducted in India report a mean age group between 45 and 54. The soft palate, floor of the mouth, buccal mucosa, and the ventral tongue are most affected. Erythroplakic lesions are flat, red, and velvety, that may or may not have regular margins. The surface of the lesion is usually smooth and homogeneous, but may also be granular or nodular, with specks of white spots interspersed in the lesion. Now, such lesions may be called erythroleukoplakia, leukoerythroplakia, speckled leukoplakia, or speckled erythroplakia. So this has been a problem that has been addressed by pathologists and researchers. There has been much confusion in designating such mixed red-white lesions, as all these terms can be interchangeably used to describe leukoplakia with red components or erythroplakia with white components. However, such a distinction may be subjective, academic, and may not have much value, as mixed red-white lesions in general have to be treated with suspicion and patients have to be under a close follow-up. The histopathology for erythroplakia may vary from showing dysplastic features, carcinoma in situ, or even invasive squamous cell carcinoma. And since most erythroplakias turn out to be either dysplastic or carcinomatous, it is generally agreed that all red lesions, either homogeneous or with white components, have to be diagnosed and treated with caution unless proven otherwise. So erythroplakia mandates effective treatment, since they have a high risk of malignant transformation. Usually, the histopathology of erythroplakia may dictate the treatment. Since most lesions show dysplasia or invasive carcinoma, a complete excision is usually the treatment of choice, and patients should be kept under a close follow-up.